capable of more than you know. So stop doubting yourself and get ready for the final battle. With me, Divya, your math facilitator. In this video, I'm going to give you the last minute tips for your final examinations. And these tips are really important because this is a time wherein you mess up with a lot of things. And these tips will help you to stay organized and give your exams comfortably. So let us quickly get into the tips. And these tips I have divided into three segments. And let us get into the first segment. So our first segment is personal care. Now you might be wondering, why is this personal care included in the exam tips? Because health is the most important thing, and only when you are healthy you can do what you want. So as you know that there is like a health emergency in the country, not only in the country, in fact in the whole world. So wherein you are asked to follow a lot of health tips. Now that you are going to write your exams, being healthy is very, very important for you. All you need to do is stay hygienic, because most of the students have this habit of biting their nails when they are tensed and putting their fingers in mouth, putting their pens in mouth when they are writing their exam. So don't do all these things. Stay hygienic. Wash your hands regularly, at least with clean water. Avoid contact with any external objects when you go to write your exam. Maximum try to avoid the contact, and if you are touching anything external, then try to wash your hands at least with clean water. This is the first personal care you have to take at this moment, and very important it is. Second tip is, you have to drink lots of water and stay hydrated. And you need a proper sleep. At least 6 to 7 hours of sleep is very important for your brain to function properly. Few students think of completing a piece of portion overnight, and this is really wrong. Trust me, you don't complete the syllabus. Instead, you start forgetting what you have already learned, because your brain doesn't function properly if you don't have a proper sleep. So 6 to 7 hours, a minimum of 6 hours sleep is really important. And eat healthy, eat fresh fruits and vegetables, and avoid junk food. And most importantly, you should avoid outside food right now. So eat healthy, eat fresh, so that your body is active, and only when your body and brain are active you can give your 100% in your examination. So take care of your health first. Now the second segment is planning. You have to plan well before your examination. Lot of students, they mess up with all things and they are in a hurry on the exam day morning. They keep running around the room searching for pen, pencil and all. So don't do that. Stock up all your stationery the night before your examination. Keep all your stationery, whatever you need, at one place. And some of the 10th board students, you're not wearing your uniforms. So plan what you want to wear on the exam day before itself, so that you don't waste time in searching for what to wear. And wear a dress in which you are comfortable with, because you're going to write your examination. And check your centers a day before your exam, because you have a center code for your center and there might be two or more schools with the same name. So it's always suggestible to check your exam centers before your exam day. So stock your stationery and all the things you need the night before the examination itself, so that you don't waste time on the exam day. Now the third segment is presentation of your paper. Now why is this very important? Because the scrutinizer is not going to look at you and give marks. They are going to look at the paper and give you marks. So the paper is very important, and it's very important how you present the paper, because you are represented by your paper. So be careful when you're presenting your paper, and here are the tips. Now as soon as you get your question paper, just go through the questions very quickly and mark with pencil the questions which you know very well. Now you're going to do the questions which you know very well first, okay? So firstly, you'll write the questions which you know very well, very neatly. Clear? So write in a good handwriting. Now this doesn't mean that now I'm asking you to go for handwriting classes and learn handwriting right now. This is not the time for it. But write in such a handwriting wherein the person who is correcting your paper will be able to understand your handwriting, which means you have to write legibly and carefully. And don't overwrite on your paper. Before starting an answer, just think for 10 to 20 seconds of what exactly you want to write. This will help you to avoid overwriting in your paper. And as far as I know, you'll get an empty paper, a plain paper, wherein you have to draw the margins. So carry a long scale with you so that it will be easy for you to draw the margin, since it will be a long paper. And give proper spacing between the word and draw lines after every answer so that it adds to the neatness of your answer sheet. Now firstly, you'll write the answers which you know very well. Then second, you'll write the answers which you know like okay. And third, finally, you will write the answers which you don't know also. Now how do you do this? Even if you don't know the answer, there might be some concept related to it, or for instance, if it is max, there might be a formula, there might be some calculation related to it. So do it, because for this you may get a 1 or 2 marks, and each mark is very important in your final exam. So don't lose these marks. Attempt all the questions in the question paper. Now since you're jumbling the questions, you're writing the questions which you know very well first. So the question numbers play a very important role here. You have to be very careful when you're numbering your answers. Now number your questions very carefully. The section name and the question number has to be very correct, because you might write the entire answer correctly and you might write a wrong question number and you end up getting a zero. So don't do that. Be careful when you're writing your question numbers. Plan in such a way that you finish your paper at least 10 minutes earlier so that you have time to recheck your answers. Sometimes it might happen that you miss answering any question, so checking is very important. And after you confirm that you have attempted all the questions, now the second step in checking is you have to go through the answers and underline or highlight the important points or the key words of the answers with pencil. This creates a very good impression on the person who is correcting your paper, because by just looking at the answer, these underlined keywords look very catchy and they are tempted to give you full marks. So the final tip is that even before entering your exam hall, don't discuss anything with your friends. Whatever you learned is done. Now you don't have to discuss anything and get panicked. And before starting your exam, once you enter into the exam hall, go for the washroom, make yourself comfortable, drink some water and sit calmly. Few students, they just turn around and talk chit-chat before the exam. So don't do that. Stay calm. It is suggestible to close your eyes and recollect the answers instead of chit-chatting with your friends. Also, after the examination, don't discuss about the paper. What has already happened is happened. Leave it, because these discussions will disturb you, they will divert you, and you lose your confidence sometimes. So it's better not to discuss the previous paper and plan for the next paper. So these are simple exam tips, but very important. All you need to do is stay positive, stay calm, work hard, make it happen, and let the people shop. So on behalf of Math Facilitator, I wish you best of luck for your examinations. And don't forget that luck favors the one who is working hard. I hope these last minute exam tips will help you to stay organized and give your exams comfortably. If you feel this video is helpful for you, then give this video a big thumbs up, share it with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe.